Namaste, I am Subin Sudhakar, second year MBA student of IIM Jammu. Today we have with us Dr. Pramod Sadarjoshi. He is the founder and CEO of Talentsmith Consulting. He is also previously associated with Microsoft, Oracle, KPMG, Citibank and JP Morgan Chase. Sir, today we'll broadly discuss about diversity in corporation.
All right.
Okay.
Pleasure meeting you.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Meeting you.
So go ahead, Sumit.
Yeah. So, sir, I have a work ex of 2 years. So,
okay.
What I have been observing is the companies, they focus a lot about diversity and inclusivity.
Yeah.
But the sad thing is either they go too much on diversity and leave inclusivity behind,
yeah,
or they go too much into inclusivity and leave diversity behind. They do not go hand in hand. So, what is your take on it?
It's very interesting. In fact, just a few minutes back, I had some of your batchmates discussing with me on the same concept.
Okay.
And actually, in fact, let me see if I got the paper. Yeah, I got it here.
Yes.
Yeah. In fact, I'll show this to you. In fact, we can show it here.
Yeah.
See,
yeah.
What's happening is, look at this. If you take the x-axis as diversity and y-axis as inclusivity or inclusiveness.
Yeah.
Now, on a 0 to 9 scale,
right,
there are companies which are on 9-1. High diversity, they'll take various people, but not enough efforts is made to get them inclusive.
Okay.
So there is interpersonal relationship issue, there's politics issue, there's a whole lot of things. But on paper, we've hired from different genders, different communities, different academic disciplines, blah, blah, blah. But where is the effort to bring in, which is what I'm hearing you say.
Yeah.
You know, conversely, there are a lot of people which are very chummy, chummy, friendly, cricket, Ganpati, this, that, everything, all festivals, you know, community gathering, all inclusiveness.
Mm-hmm.
But what the heck, there's no diversity in thinking.
Yeah.
So I want to go, Subin, beyond gender and other stuff.
Okay.
I want to talk of diversity of intellect.
That's
I want to talk of inclusivity of intellect, which means, let's say if somebody is at 9-1, I want people with very diverse backgrounds and thinking, which includes challenging me if I'm the boss, challenging the process. Well, that's when you get diversity of thought process.
Yeah.
And being very intellectually democratic about it,
mm-hmm,
you know, really soliciting a lot of ideas. I also want to have people who are very friendly and warm and inclusive, as in a great bond. Otherwise, you know, a bunch of prima donnas, I call them prima donnas, very big, but not getting along well.
Mm-hmm.
What the heck? You won't achieve your objectives.
Yeah.
Conversely, I don't want a bunch of nice middle, it's called social club managers.
Okay.
You know, social club members.
Yeah, so they don't have a chat.
Yeah, you pat my back,
nothing
pat my back.
Yeah.
Nothing productive and nobody's challenging status quo.
Hmm.
So if I were to actually look at it, you need to strike this wonderful balance between x-axis and y-axis. So can you get to a 9-9 where you get this amazing, awesome talent, no compromise on that, with diverse thinking, background, academic discipline, gender and what have you.
Yeah.
And yet, create an atmosphere of inclusiveness,
so,
of empathy, of ideation, you know, so that then, you know, because if you skew a little here, it becomes prima donna.
Yeah.
If you skew a little here, it becomes a social club.
Mm.
Okay, and therefore you need to really strike this one.
Okay.
And that's very important. You're right, many companies speak about this, very few companies get the two equations together in a very balanced way.
So
I just introduced somebody about this.
Yeah. So I just want to ask, since you had a vast area of experience, so how can companies get from here till here? What are the steps they have
from here till here?
Yeah, and from here till here.
Okay, wonderful. That's a great question. All right. So firstly, when you take diversity from here, now where is this group lacking? They're lacking in camaraderie, team building and all that. I will sort of get these guys to become very empathetic and inclusive. I'll get them.
Okay.
This group, very nice, chummy guys, I'll get them to increase their intellectual prowess.
Mm-hmm.
I will challenge them on their IQ. I'll challenge them on their ability to get things done.
Yeah.
I will also train them to get a little cerebral and value add. Because this is a business enterprise, if it's a business enterprise, okay? I mean, it's a commercial organization.
Mm-hmm.
You need to get the bottom lines right and top lines right.
Yeah.
So I will up the IQ level, the competency matrix, the competencies, companions, all that I'll get these guys to up and about, and then get them to move here. And then you have an amazing, formidable team with great intellect and yet very inclusive people. They're not a teacher's throw trying to prove one-upmanship, which is what happens if you're very high here, right? Whether gender-related or academics-related or prowess-related.
Mm-hmm.
This one, one very nice, mediocre group, but guess what? There is no intellectual property. There is no challenging of thinking. And this a lot of bosses in this are my way or highway kind of a people. Mm. So you need to deal with both them and get them to convergence.
Yeah. So sir, let me come to the state of Jammu and Kashmir.
Okay.
Okay. So now that the Article 370 has been taken off, and we have in institutions like IIM inside in a state called in Jammu and Kashmir.
Yeah.
So we are trying to develop those people.
Yeah.
Include them in this.
Yeah.
Increase our diversity.
Yeah.
So how can IIM Jammu do it?
Again, I'm not an expert on 377. I'm not a political commentator.
Yeah.
But as a professional, if I want to comment,
yeah,
where IIMs can contribute and IIM Jammu can contribute is make people feel involved in every which decision that's going to impact the development of the state.
Mm.
Okay? You can create that culture and that environment. Culture is very important.
Yeah.
Alright? At the same time, you guys can do one good thing. Create also an atmosphere to attract good people here.
Yeah.
Good companies. Really world brands. Get them here. How do you do that? You've got to tell them it's safe.
Mm.
It's ease of business,
yeah,
it's productivity oriented,
yeah,
and you'll get quality brains here also.
Yeah.
Only then you'll be able to attract the working capital, the companies investing here,
mm,
and really build a huge infrastructure.
Yeah.
At the same time, tell them it's extremely safe here,
mm,
and this with the companies. With the people, you make them feel involved.
Yeah.
And you know what, the best way to get them involved is give them work opportunities, job opportunities, and get them involved in decision making.
Yeah.
Because guess what? Who knows context best? The locals.
The locals. Yes.
They know it best. Get the locals up, excited,
yeah,
and energized.
Yes, sir. So actually, in this context, we have already started an incubation center in.
Wonderful.
Yeah, in Srinagar.
So wonderful. I think that's really,
yeah,
laudable effort,
yeah,
especially given the context.
Mm.
It could not have been more well timed.
Yeah. So how did you find Jammu, sir?
Well, this is my first visit
time?
Here,
okay,
first time,
yeah,
and I've not gone out yet.
Okay.
I've been here yesterday and also I've been to the campus.
Raghunath Bazaar you can reach.
I know, I'm told, so I've not been anywhere outside.
Huh.
Patel and the conference here,
okay,
I've done that. So I'd love to explore,
yeah,
but obviously from what I've seen is people are very warm and friendly here.
Yeah.
And they're very natural, very spontaneous.
Mm.
So, but I haven't really interacted with a lot of people or gone around,
mm,
to give a very authentic comment on that. But I'm sure it's going to be a great place if I sort of stick around and explore.
So thank you, sir.
Yeah.
It's come to the end of the interview.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
It was great having you here.
Yeah.
Your addresses were all like, it was like, we were thinking somewhere out of the box, not within the boundaries.
Yes. Yes.
So that made the day also special.
Thank you. I enjoyed both my keynote address this morning, as well as the panel discussion on transformation leadership.
Mm.
So it's all about transforming organizations through leadership. And one of the biggest things, I would like to say two things. Get courage and conviction, and get inclusiveness back with the science of design thinking, and most important, get rid of unconscious bias.
Sure.
I think the biggest deterrent could be unconscious bias, then you're reaching to where you are. And of course, I must compliment, great infrastructure, great team work, and great bonhomie. I think I really enjoyed speaking and very great panel and wonderful. I really enjoyed it.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot.
Thank
Wish you all the best and to greater heights.
Thank you, sir.
All
Thanks
right.
a lot.
Thank you.